The support that Juan Guaido has right now, it's apparently bigger than the government. I say this because since the beginning of the protests, more and more places of Caracas and different spots in the country have been going to the streets, have been taking the streets, just to make it clear that they don't want this government anymore. They want an open path for transition. Now, the support that Nicolas Maduro has right now on the ground, it's not as it used to be. Of course, they have people, it's obvious. They have supporters, but how much more time will that last? When we saw the demonstrations on the 23rd, we saw at least tens of thousands of people in the opposition's rally, while in the government's rally, because the government called for a demonstration that same day, we saw maybe 200 tops, 300 in one spot. So right now, the situation is so critical that everyone, even supporters, all supporters of Hugo Chavez, are suffering the consequences, are suffering hunger, starvation, lack of food, lack of medicine. This is a crisis that is touching everyone right now. But yes, it's definitely, we have two scenarios. We have Nicolas Maduro claiming the presidency, Nicolas Maduro saying that everything is okay and that he was capable of controlling the situation. And then we see a different reality. We see Juan Guaido calling to the streets with people, with the international community, and, you know, giving certain steps and secure steps all the way.
Nicolas Maduro in the past few days has spoken about the danger, his concern that people may take up arms and there may be some sort of conflict within Venezuela itself. And then there's the concern. How big is the concern that the Americans may send troops into Venezuela?
Well, there is concern, definitely. It's a big concern. First, that this might turn into a civil war, that this might turn into another 2017 where more than 150 people were killed during protests, where 2014, where more than 50 people were killed during protests. That on one side. On the other, yes, there are thoughts and people who think that this might be the door for the United States to come to for a new invasion, though experts say it's not the most possible scenario that we can face. It is definitely a threat for the government. But the truth is that this is the interesting part. I was talking to this protester during the 23rd in the opposition rally, and I said, are you afraid that this might turn into something really violent? And he said, well, this is a very violent city. Either you get killed in a protest or you get killed, you know, outside while, I don't know, maybe shopping or in your car. So honestly, I'd rather die on the streets fighting for freedom than because I'm getting robbed. And that is more or less the feeling. This is people, we're talking to people that have nothing to lose. They have nothing left to lose. And that's the sentiment right now on the street.